Whisky. It's mainly a drink. It can come in elegant bottles, and in cases where it's scarce and old, it can be treated like an investment, but most people would agree that it serves the purpose of being a drink. That's simple enough, but it's important, because it's hard to share the experience of a drink on Instagram. Or if you're buying a bottle online that you haven't tried, it's hard to get an impression of how good that drink is. We have whisky notes, the creation of which is quite an art in itself, but then of course there are ratings. A high rating will make someone think a whisky might be good, a low rating might make someone think a whisky is bad. There are many rating systems for whisky. Almost all the ones I know of give a score to different categories and then add that score up, leaving you with a number. For example, Jim Murray gives scores out of 25 to the nose, taste, finish and balance of the whisky, adding up to a score out of 100. Nick's Wine Merchants have developed a spider system, which essentially breaks down the four categories into 10, and then scores out of 10 for each lead to a total out of 100. This is okay, numbers make it easier to put things in order, but there's a sense in which a score of 90 might not be that useful in communicating the overall goodness of a whisky. Firstly, whisky is something that can be satisfying on multiple levels. With these added up scores, a whisky with a mediocre taste can be compensated for with a nice smell. And can I really tell the difference between a 23 and a 24? I'm much more likely to use a linguistic scale for ratings. Here's something close to what mine looks like. But once I've rated a whisky over these subcategories on this scale, how do I put it together into an overall rating that somehow conveys both the quality of the whisky and the breadth of categories it scored well on? There's no meaningful way to add these the same way that I would numbers. Well, I like Japanese whisky, and that seems like a good enough excuse to use an aggregation method developed by a researcher from Japan called Sugeno. The way to apply Sugeno's method in the case of whisky basically works something like this. A good whisky is one which is good across a set of criteria which, together, make a good whisky. So I need to establish my preferences on what I think makes a good whisky. And I need to think about how all these criteria interact with each other. So let's put this all together to give an overall rating to this whisky. Well, it's at least good, because for all of the criteria I thought it was at least good. Is it nice? Well, I gave a rating of at least nice to taste, mouthfeel, and finish. And you might have noticed before, these three criteria, when they're all working, produce a nice whisky. Could it be a wow whisky? Well, I only rated it wow on taste and mouthfeel. And if we have a look at how those criteria work together, I thought that that only produces a good whisky. So, overall, this one is going to be nice. Remember, a good whisky is one which is at least good across a set of criteria which together make a good whisky. So a nice whisky is one which is at least nice across a set of criteria which together make a nice whisky. And so with a rating system like this, I hope we can all start communicating with each other meaningfully about how good our whisky tastes.